Jenkins, darling.
I'm not shouting.
You are, dear. It's supposed to be your age.
I'm not in my grave yet.
No, not yet.
No, you have a good many years yet. Hasn't he, Cuthbert? Hasn't he?
Sorry. A bread crumb from the bread roll. I went down the wrong way. I was just saying to my wife earlier on how, well, Lord Duval, look.
You're the only six-year-old I know, Lord Duval.
I'm glad somebody thinks so. You bring a touch of spring to these occasions, Mavis.
I do believe you're blushing, Mavis.
It's the heat. It's almost as bad as the Congo.
It is damn hot in here. I'll get Jenkins to turn the damn heat down. Parlourmaid! Get Jenkins to turn the damn heat down.
Aren't you supposed to live in a warm climate, Uncle, since you returned to Greece with that illness?
Everyone seems to be so concerned with my health, which is funny as you're all, with the exception of Mavis, after my money. One day, I'll surprise you and have a son.
I wish you wouldn't shout, dear. She's dropped the sweets.
I'm so sorry. It just slipped. I'm so sorry. I'll go see if it's got another.
You just can't get your servant these days.
We'll make sure it doesn't happen again.
Now look at what you've done. I'll have to go comfort them. Can't get good servants these days.
We've been through our fair share of servants just recently.
Don't tell everyone, darling.
They'll think we've been bumping them off.
Thank you.
the greatest detective.
I wouldn't say that.
You're too modest, sir.
Your record proves it. I expect you know who did this.
I think you'd better take a look at the doctor's report.
This isn't a murder at all. It's heart failure. He hit his head on the billiard table as he fell, I should say.
Have you ever heard of Frank Mutalis, Doctor?
I can't say that I have.
A deadly African poison that makes its victims look as if he's had a heart attack. Look under his fingernails with this magnifying glass.
Yes, they look yellowish. Think how much red about it. God, brilliant, Smith.
What do we do then, sir?
Lord Vaughan knew an attempt would be made on his life. That's why I'm here. We should have the guests in, one by one.
May I make liberty suggesting we see the butler first? I apprehended he's ran out the gates.
Good idea, Sergeant. Call the butler.
You wish to see me, sir?
What do you know of Frank Mutalis?
Nothing, sir.
Why were you so nervous at dinner?
I'd rather not say.
You have access to and serve the wines where the poison could have been.
I never did have been, before God I didn't.
You're an ex-convict, aren't you?
How did you know that?
By the way you walked. Lord Devon knows you if you left his service.
Shall I retain then, sir?
I think not, Sergeant. You may go, Jenkins.
Call the parlourmaids.
Why did you drop the sweet at dinner?
It was Lord Devon shouting. It upset me.
I think not.
It was.
You dropped the sweet when you mentioned a son.
What's that got to do with everything?
Because her son is also Lord Duval's son.
How did you know?
A little gossip at the local inn. The case of two and two making four. He threatened to, you killed him, he threatened to expose you. He wanted an heir.
Shall I ask them then, sir?
I think that might be a bit hasty, Sergeant. Call in Mr. and Mrs. Black Hawkins. Lord Duval was consistently rude about your looks. He couldn't bear on a track.
destructive women are.
And that valuable necklace you stood to inherit gave you reason to poison him as you sat near him at dinner.
Shall I turn then, sir?
No, Sergeant. She has not the courage to murder. You can see in her behaviour. Call in her brother, the last suspect.
I think you've a damn confounded cheek. Why should I want to poison my uncle?
Who mentioned poison?
Yes,
who did?
The butler told me.
I will be blunt with you as well, Mr. Alderson Treke. You're in debt up to your eyebrows, and the merchant bank you stood to inherit would pay them off.
Gad, how did you know that?
I have my contacts in the murky world of the gambler.
Shall I tell him then, sir?
I think not. He can know nothing of the poison. He's never left the country.
I am baffled, sir. You said he was the last suspect.
There was one poor guest, Miss Fonsbury Jones. Yet she's the only one without a motive.
I'm baffled, sir.
Think while I'm in. I know you did not want to murder Lord Duval, so there is no need to cry, Miss Jones.
I can't help it.
I say you didn't want to murder him, but no, because you loved him.
I told nobody. How did you know?
It's written in your eyes, Miss Jones. I say you did not want to murder him, but unfortunately you did, didn't you?
What do you mean?
She knew of her husband's affair with Lady Duval and put the poison in his wine glass. But because the butler made such a mess of setting the table at dinner, Lord Duval drank the poison by mistake.
Oh gosh.
Her remark about the Congo gave her away. I knew then she'd been to Africa. Arrest the wretched woman, Sergeant.
You come down to the station with me, sir.
I'm afraid not, Sergeant. I have to catch the boat to New York. The police are baffled by a multi-murder case. Good night, Sergeant.
Good night, sir.